Hey, what's up, everyone? It's your boy Matt Diazbo coming at you with a new album review, and this one is in my series called Did I Miss Anything? Where I go back and listen to an album that I might have never known about, forgotten, or skipped over because I didn't think it was interesting or I just didn't care, but I'm now listening to it because I have this channel and I want to talk about music with you and everybody. And today I am checking out the album. Well, I already checked it out, but I'm reviewing Scatterbrain with their album Here Comes Trouble. Scatterbrain was a thrash metal slash groove metal band out from, if I'm correct, Los Angeles, California. I discovered this album because I've done some collaborations with some YouTubers where we listen to different albums that we all select and give our opinion on them. And on this particular one, it was like live, erased, listen, where you would have to listen to an album for the rest of your out life, see a band only one time. For like you can only see them perform once, this album one time, and slash erase this album from history altogether. And one of the YouTubers I collabed with, his name was JC Rock Reviews. I'll put his channel down below. He's the one who suggested this album, and the whole game format or listening format was made up for my friend Chilli. I'll put his channel down there as well. This album is called Here Comes Trouble, and that is definitely a great way to title this album because it is really out there and not in the best way, I think. The best way to describe this album, it is a clashing of different genres, whether it be metal, funk, or ska from the 90s with some really, really bad vocals. It's just rough all around. And I don't know if it was like how it's supposed to be back in the 90s. It was supposed to be rough, but it hasn't aged that well. And I think a prime example of that, well, like how bad this album has aged is on the song Drunken Milkman. Don't really know what to say about the song. It's just all over the place. So check it out.
Flash. Oh, crash. Milk and blood. Blood and milk, milk and blood, blood and milk.
Weird. Now, if you don't take this album pretty seriously, you can have some fun with it with some of the cheesy and goofy lyrics and sounds on this record, especially on the song Don't Call Me Dude. Like I said, if you're not really thinking on a high level and just enjoying it for what it is, it's not that bad. It's just really, really silly. So here's a clip of that for you. Yeah, it's pretty enjoyable if you're not caring about it and just having a good time with it. But if you really want to take this album seriously, it's plagued with really bad mixes and overall production choices. And the fact that like they mush all these genres together is just very messy and inconsistent and not very cohesive, it feels like. At one point on the album, they're like taking 10 different guitar riffs, drum patterns, vocal patterns from other like huge legacy bands and kind of mush it into one song. And I think at the time they're trying to be clever and funny with it, but it just comes off really incoherent and just all over the place. So I want to play a clip of Down With The Ship for you so you can get a sense of just that messiness they have here.
I wanna do what's right for me.
It's all over the place. So yeah, the band's name is Scatterbrain, and after listening to this album, you will feel very scatterbrained with the poor production choices, the wild musical choices, the weird vocal patterns. Just everything on here is kind of just bad. But like I said, if you take it seriously, it's bad. But if you're just having fun with it and not really taking it seriously, it can be a halfway okay, fun album at times. Just with some really, really bad production, you could say. Now, do I think I missed out on anything with this album? I gotta say, at least with this album, I don't know about Scatterbrain as a whole, but this particular album, I definitely did not miss out on anything. I think it's something that I need. I feel like it doesn't really impact my life in terms of musical taste and choices. It's just something that was there that I missed because I was too young for it, and okay, I'm okay with that. I can live without that. With that being said, I would say this album, at least ranking wise, scoring wise, I would give it a okay to like light 4 out of 10. Links down below. Tell me what you, if you ever listened to this band, wherever, if you've seen them live back in the day, if you have any thoughts about this band, let me know. And until next time, guys, I will see you in the pit.
Good things about